ஏ கைஸ் இந்த வீடியோவில் வந்து குவால்காம் ஆஃப் கேம்பஸோட செலெக்ஷன் ப்ரொசீஜர் தான் பார்க்க போகிறோம். ஸோ இதில் வந்து எத்தனை ரவுண்டு இருந்துச்சு, ஒரு ரவுண்ட்லேயும் வந்து இன்டர்வியூவில் என்னெல்லாம் கொஸ்டின்ஸ் கேட்டாங்க, ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்காக ஒயர்லெஸ் கம்யூனிகேஷன் ரிலேட்டடாக என்னெல்லாம் கொஸ்டின்ஸ் கேட்டாங்க, என்னென்னலாம் ரிப்பீட்டட் கொஸ்டின்ஸ் இருந்துச்சு, ப்ரோக்ராமிங்கில் என்னெல்லாம் கொஸ்டின்ஸ் கேட்டாங்க, இந்த மாதிரி எல்லா கொஸ்டின்ஸ்க்கான ஆன்சர்ஸும் இந்த வீடியோவில் இருக்குது. ஸோ மறக்காமல் வீடியோ ஸ்கிப் பண்ணாமல் பாருங்கள். உங்களுக்கு எந்த செக்ஷன் போகணுமோ டைம் லைனில் வந்து அந்த செக்ஷன் இருக்கும், அங்கே கிளிக் பண்ணி போய் பாருங்கள். ஸோ இந்த டைம் ஸ்டாம்ப் எல்லாமே டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்லேயும் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கமெண்ட்லேயும் இருக்குது. So, vanga po video kula polam.
Harish, how are you?
Hi, Kaushik. I'm fine. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. So, generally, these kind of interactions, we'll be like asking intro from that person. But actually, I want to give intro for you. Like, Harish is actually a good friend of mine, and like, he's like such a dedicated hard worker, and like, he's like very talented fellow also. Like, he's my best. He was my best mate, and he was my college mate also. So, okay, this video is all about like how I made to Qualcomm. Qualcomm is your dream company, right?
Yes. It was my dream company, and I'm happy that I'm working for Qualcomm.
Actually, when did you like start preparing for Qualcomm?
Qualcomm is one of the companies that comes in our college. So we started preparation for like during our third year. From third year, we started to prepare for core companies. Yeah, after that, I couldn't get through in on campus. So after that, after some time, I applied off campus and I got the opportunity.
What are the roles like taken by Qualcomm in your college?
That nobody knows here. It depends on like they just take and they put on random roles like that we are not aware. Some people might get into hardware and some might go into software roles.
You're from ECE, right?
Yes, I'm from ECE.
Okay. I know that you are working in some communication systems related thing. So communication systems itself is a very vast subject, right? So like if you could tell like what are the things to prefer, prepare for, like we have analog, digital, so and so, like you could like point out like 5 to 6 important things in each topic so that we can prepare for Qualcomm.
My area of interest was communication system, and basically like we need to be aware like from scratch, like what is analog communication and digital communication and wireless communication. And from that, RF and microelectronics also we need like some basics. Along with that, like what is the current trend, like 4G, 5G, like we need to relate those things like from the fundas, like how this communication working in 4G and 5G, because that is industry trend, right? And we need to correlate that with that our subject. Like that is very much important. I can say that it is enough from a college, like analog and digital, what our faculty teaches, right? That is enough. And apart from that, you can refer some YouTube channels for wireless communication, right? I used Aditya K. Jagannathan sir's YouTube video. It will be very good for wireless communication.
So Qualcomm is also like seeing any importance in internships and like the courses you do?
They just ask for during the interviews, like what are our experiences, things like if you have done any internship, they'll ask questions from our resume. So in that way, it will be helpful if you do some internships and things.
May I know where you have done your internship?
Finally, I've done my internship in IIT Madras in 5G testbed lab, like which helped me to learn much more about a communication system, where I practically worked on some modules which I could tell to interviews during my interview process.
Let's assume a person A, okay? So that person is having some area like history of areas, and if he is applying for off campus for Qualcomm through off campus, is it possible for him to like make it for the interview? Like
that I am not sure, but still if we are like we are very good in it, and if they think like that candidate is very perfect for that role, they will definitely will check his profile and they will call for interviews.
So just brief about how you applied for Qualcomm, like how the process went, how many rounds, and what are the questions you faced?
Before that, like I started to apply for only modem software engineer roles because that suited my area of interest. So okay. I applied for modem software roles and I got
to So like, did you apply through Qualcomm careers website or through LinkedIn or Naukri, like kind of?
I just applied over the Qualcomm portal.
No referral, it's completely through applying, right?
Yeah, we can either go for, if somebody gives you referral also, it will be helpful, or you can directly apply in the Qualcomm.
You went through direct applications, right?
Yes. First one will be screening, or it will be a telephonic call. It might, like, just they will ask questions from your resume and things like if we if they think like we are perfect for that role, then they will schedule interviews like that. So that was my first call, telephonic interview, which they mostly questions were from internships and some basic questions on our communication system and questions from resume. Okay. So which was easy, and I almost answered most of the questions. They just say the way we answer and how strong are we in fundas. And followed by that, after a week, I got a call from HR, like they are scheduling interview for me. And then, yeah, that was my like screening process to real interview.
Even that interview contained technical questions, right?
Yeah, only technical questions. Yeah. Then they scheduled me, they after a week, they called me for a video call.
Okay.
And very first technical round was for about an hour. They started questions from my internship very firstly.
Okay.
Which I did in IIT Madras.
Okay.
And they started to ask basic questions from communication system, like what is an RF block diagram, what are the advantages and disadvantages of modulation schemes, OFDM, like what are the advantages and disadvantages of OFDM, which is used in 4G, and what is the modulation that is used in 5G, and like so many questions from communication system, like we have to explain in a very clear way how it works from block diagram, like what is the advantages and what are the disadvantages of each block and why it is used, like that we have to explain in scratch.
Okay, so like so, you would have interviewed through like online, right? So like how do you manage to explain those kind of things? Like
correct. Like I use pen and paper and showed them like this is the block diagram and this is how the signal receive and this modulation demodulation how it goes.
Wow.
And like that we can use pen and paper and can show them like that. And they also help you a lot, like if you are stuck somewhere they'll help you. Give you some clues like that. And at the end of like after 40 minutes or so, they started entering into programming round. They started asking from linked list, doubly linked list. They asked me to write code for it, write code for how to add a doubly linked list and how to remove a element from doubly linked list like that. So we have to share our screen, like how do we write code. So he asked me to share the screen. And it was basic, so I was able to get through that. And he also helped me, like, why are you going in this way? Like, he helped, the interviewer helped me a lot.
Would you like brief about your second and third rounds?
Like, second round was another manager. Like, he asked me, like, starting, like, some questions were repeated from interview one. The repeated questions were, like, from modulation techniques, like CDMA, FDMA, and TDMA. Like, what are the advantages and disadvantages of each, like which we are used in like from 1G to 5G, like how that technologies like change, like what was the advantages one over the other. And then that was repeated many times. And then like advantages of modulation techniques like 16 form, where it is 16 form, and other modulation types which are used, millimeter waves, and which is used in 5G technologies. Those were questions which were asked many times over the interview. Like from it was asked in interview one and interview two. And then he asked me from how antenna, from antennas he started to ask, like antenna subject.
Okay.
There were some questions like how, like if a based like interferences, how avoided, like in when there are multiple cells like that. He asked me some questions, some scenario-based questions from communication. And then he started to ask from programming questions from basic C, like okay. Pointers, arithmetic.
Oh.
He asked me to share the screen. Like he had some questions written and okay. I have to answer in some 5 seconds like that.
Oh.
Like array and address, and I have to give the correct address where it is stored. And
oh.
Like each question he had only gave me 5 seconds. I have to answer within that.
Okay.
Like some yeah. questions were there. And then after that, third round was managerial.
Okay.
Like they asked me so many scenario based questions and some puzzles. Most of the questions are I was not sure about the answer, but still he helped me to like the one which they are seeing is like how we approach to the solution. most of the interviews were checking like how we are approaching to the solution. And if you're stuck somewhere, they were really helpful. And then third round was managerial. And after that, a week, I got a call from HR, like they are going to provide offer for me. Yeah, okay. It was that.
So according to your statement, I get like even for communications role, you must be having an integration or integrated knowledge of both communication systems and coding, programming also.
Yes.
And
because
like,
software.
Okay, yeah.
It is software based role. So like every interview, like we'll have programming and the subjects which we learned in our UG days.
Okay. So like you are telling like I had some questions in like C programming, like is that a mandatory thing? Like you must answer only in C programming? Like were they asking like specifically asking like you should answer in C programming or like can also?
It was only on C programming. Like
so according to your statement, I get like people should get their fundamentals very strong, right? So
yeah, that is very true.
Instead of like focusing,
like if you are very good at fundamentals, that is what they expect. They don't expect much from our current technologies. But if you are very good at fundas and how it is applied over here, that is what their expectation. And if you meet that, they'll really appreciate. Like,
if you don't mind, like you could tell your estimate, like approximate package, like what you are actually getting.
Yeah, here now 14 MBA. Just do so many projects as you can, and do more projects that build your resume very well, so that you could showcase in your during your interview process. Because if you do some good projects, you will be able to explain to our interviewers, and they ask most of the questions from projects and internships. So you will be very strong if you've done some projects, right? Because you will know much more things. And you have to do project which relates to your subject. That is more important.
So like you don't like you have received questions on many topics, like any precise topic you have received more questions on.
Yeah, that was like modulations came from digital modulation, like digital communication. Most of the questions were from digital modulation, digital communication, like what is the modulation scheme used in every RAD technologies, like what are the advantages of that and disadvantages of that, and what is millimeter wave, which is being used in 5G now, like that. Like most of the questions were from digital and wireless. Yeah, fading, what is ISI and things that affect the communication channel, and then program.
So what do you think as perks of working in Qualcomm?
Yeah, we can work in a cutting edge technology, that is obvious. Like Qualcomm is a pioneer in 5G, and we can work in cutting edge technologies. Yeah, that is one. You'll get a good learning experience.
So like were they shortlisting on CGPA criteria? Were they looking on it like while selecting for off campus also?
I'm not aware of that actually. I don't know like if they use CGPA as a criteria, but mostly for profile suits for that job profile, then they'll surely will call us for interview or test.
As per your suggestion, what would be the optimum CGPA we can maintain to make it to some big companies like Qualcomm?
Like it is fine, like if you have 7.5 and 8 above, if you are going from B, if you are going from B, like 7.5 and 8 is fine.
What are your like future career plans?
Yeah, just move on like to work on coming technologies and go for a good level. Yeah, that's it.